that failed. That's Wally Muhammad with Drew Brown. Beautiful evening here in the Bahamas. Angelo Dundee is in the ring, the veteran trainer of Muhammad Ali since the first couple of fights of his career. The crowd is starting to chant Ali, Ali, like old times. Ali is 6'3", but Trevor Berbick is not small, he's 6'2½". Ali is almost 40 years old. Trevor Berbick is 27. Ali may be the first one in the ring. I don't see any sign of Trevor Berbick anywhere. He is reported to have said that he wouldn't move until Ali moved. Big crowd in front of Ali. Here he comes.
What a production this has turned out to be, huh? Great production.
That was some entrance. He's a very somber person.
He also has the colors of the Bahamas. Also, the borderline trim is all the Bahama colors.
Yes, you're right. Bundini Brown's got all Bahamian colors.
Very serious group around Muhammad Ali, Wally Muhammad, Drew Brown. Nobody smiling. Angelo Dundee is the most lighthearted of the group. There in the left-hand corner, Trevor Berbick has not put in an appearance yet. He's a guy who went 15 rounds with Larry Holmes, was not knocked out. I'm talking about Berbick. Muhammad Ali's last fight was against Larry Holmes, and he was forced to stop the fight in his corner.
You'll never see Muhammad Ali more somber than he is right now.
I've never seen the people around him that somber.
Yeah, everybody.
I wonder if he's thinking of that knockout by Holmes in the 12th round. He must question his ability. He must.
Sure.
He's a very rational person. He finally smiled over at us, Dave.
Yes, he did. He winked at us and smiled over. That's a good sign.
We're still waiting for Trevor Berbick to come in. He's the party of the second part. almost a forgotten man. Still limbering up lightly. Zach Clayton is in the ring, so is Nelson Chipman, so we're not sure yet who is the referee. Trevor Berbick is on his way. He's sauntering in a little bit faster than Muhammad Ali did.
Zach Clayton is the referee for this fight.
Is it definite?
Definite.
I just see him in there. He's still got his windbreaker on. Okay, Zach Clayton. One of the best referees in the country is going to work this fight. The return to action of Muhammad Ali. His first fight since October 2nd, 1980. A little over a year ago.
I don't know why the other referee is not getting out of the ring.
Jim Hill has joined us at ringside, and it's possible that Tommy Hearns may join us later. I'm Don Dunstan, along with Davey Pearl and Randy Shields. Trevor Berbick came into the ring on Bill Muhammad's corner. That's quite a surprise. Muhammad Ali is ignoring him as he dances around the ring. Jim, welcome to ringside. Where were you all night?
I have been all over the place, Don, I tell you. But I have enjoyed the things and the people that I've talked to. And you guys have just been doing a marvelous job. The drama has really come to the mat here. You know, we were thinking about all the controversy and everything else that's happened over the last 4 or 5 weeks. But we've had some pretty good bouts here.
Fantastic bouts.
Jim, let me tell you this. It's easy to do a good fight, and we've had nothing but good fights tonight, so they're easy to do.
That's absolutely right. When I talked to Ernie Shavers yesterday, and I talked to him today before he went in the ring, he said, "Hey, I talked to my wife, and all she said, go."
But there are the graphics that tell you the statistics on the young man. Muhammad Ali, 236, the heaviest of his career by far, and Berbick is 218. Size-wise, though, there isn't a great deal of difference. Berbick's 6'2½", and Ali is 6'3". Berbick seems a happy young man in there, at 27. He's a lot younger than the 39-year-old coming up to 40, Muhammad Ali. He'll be 40 in January.
Ali's got 4 inches in reach on Berbick, which maybe should be to his advantage.
It would have been in the old days when
sure.
He had that speed. Now.
Well, we got to take everything we can get now,
ladies and gentlemen, at ringside for this fight, the Minister of Sport, the Honorable.
We'll be going up to Matt Helwitz, the announcer, in a few minutes.
Wilfred Copley, Hassan Brown, Charlie Major Sr., Harold Pinder, Sammy Isaacs, George McKinney.
Well, all I can say, it's been a most enjoyable evening.
The judges for this bout, Alonzo.
Congratulations to the winners, and we're sorry for the losers, but that's the name of the game, win and lose. There have been some fights. Ernie Shavers getting off the floor when I thought he was gone in the first round.
Wasn't that an amazing
unbelievable
comeback? It really was. And you know, from the people that I've talked to, and Randy and Don, I don't know, you know how you feel about it, but they know, deep down in their hearts, they know that Ali shouldn't be in here. But still, to them, he is a sentimental favorite.
That's no question
Very
about that.
Very much so.
Well, Ernie Shavers shouldn't have been in there either, especially in the first round.
I'm telling you.
Where are you going to see a better fight than Hearns and Singletary?
No. Where would you see a better fight?
You know, for continuous action, I rated that above the Leonard fight. For continuous action.
Yes. Yeah, there were a lot rounds in the Leonard fight.
Right.
A lot of slow rounds.
Exactly.
Davey, as you look at this fight now, we look at Ali, we see the concentration in his face and his eyes. An athlete's eyes will tell you a great deal about himself. You've been in the ring many, many times. What do you think of going through these guys' minds right now? Because you've been in there.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Berbick is wondering how good and how fast Ali will be. Ali wants to win this fight. He's got to win this fight. I've talked to people in this camp all week. And he's never been more serious in his life.
Trevor Berbick introduced.
Fighting out of the blue corner at 236 pounds, three times the former heavyweight champion in the world, the great Muhammad Ali.
Listen to the hand for the great ex-champion. It's like old times here in Nassau in the Bahamas. However, I'll say that Trevor Berbick is the more carefree of the two.
You ready?
All right.
Zach Clayton, the referee, has not yet taken off his windbreaker. Zach Clayton, a great basketball star with the Harlem Globetrotters years ago, has still got that magic in his feet. He can move around the ring.
Here it is.
Berbick and Ali meeting face to face.
This is your fight. And all I want is a good, clean fight.
This is Zach Clayton.
This morning, your representative was briefed on the rules and regulations of the Commonwealth. A few of the rules I think is most important to rehash. Number one, that in the event of a knockdown, the boxer getting knocked down must take an 8-second count, kneeling or standing. It makes no difference. The boxer scoring the knockdown must go to the furthest neutral corner, remain there till he's told to resume fighting. If you come out before I order you to, I'm gonna send you back. Number two, that in the event of a knockdown and the bell sounds while the contestant's on the ground, the count will continue. If it doesn't rise before the count reaches 10, it's an automatic knockout. Number three, the three knockdown rules is in effect. And even the three knockdowns in any given round, the fight is already over. Protect yourself at all times because you're on your own. Mr. Dundee, you have any questions?
No.
You in charge of your corner.
Yes.
I'll hold you responsible for your corner. Mr. Black, are you have any questions?
No questions.
I'll hold you responsible for your corner. Check out hands now, come out fighting at the bell. Good luck, both of you. All right, there it is.
Take some of that cream.
One thing to add to what Zach Clayton said, a man cannot be saved by the bell except in the last round. All right, here it is. The comeback by Muhammad Ali.
Drama of the Bahamas, now about
Drama
to begin.
Drama in the Bahamas. Trevor Berbick wearing the white trunks with the red stripe and border. Muhammad Ali wearing the McGregor trunks, the white trunks, black stripe and border. And Zach Clayton is the referee. Bell for round one is scheduled for 10. Ali pecking away with the jab. The crowd is in a bedlam already.
Oh, what a beautiful left hand.
Ali is landing first.
Better.
Ali getting in a couple of right hands in this round so far.
Ali looking very good. Trevor Berbick catching him with a slight counterpunch right hand. No devastating punches landed yet.
Come on, clean it up and get it and work right.
They're standing close together. It is not the Ali of old dancing around the ring. He's going to be a puncher all the way, apparently.
All right, keep it clean, that's all. That's all. Come on, work and stop talking.
You can hear the referee, Zach Clayton. Scheduled for 10 rounds.
Keep talking.
The pace is slow so far.
Well, Ali is looking very good, except he's looking a little awkward. Some good punches landed by Berbick.
Berbick has been going to the body. A vulnerable spot for an older man. Berbick's gloves way down low. Good exchange for both of them. Berbick trying to roll with the punches. Sidestep them. Berbick is moving in. A terrific left hook to the body.
I don't think that punch is low.
I don't think it is, but the referee told him to keep him up.
That was a push.
Berbick is rocked back into the ropes, but he comes right off.
Nope, that was a push.
The crowd thinks it was a punch. They're really yelling. Ali has taken some good punches here. Berbick working on the body. Break him up, says Zach. Half a minute to go in the round, and it's a good round. A very good round. Better than any round of the Holmes fight for Ali. Ali rocked back by that left hand.
Ali's looking to land that combination, but he's thrown him too far over.
Berbick is taking this one seriously, too.
Berbick is really rocking to the body. He's throwing everything. He's throwing wild and crazy.
That's a great round. Great round. I would hope that Muhammad Ali would pace himself a little bit to make sure he doesn't poop out.
Well, those punches to the body, the way Ali is coming down on top of him, will make Ali more tired in the later rounds. One fact that he's getting hit, and the second is that he's straining to push him away and hold him down.
The crowd has kept up a bedlam since this fight started. We can't hear ourselves here at ringside.
Get back, Berbick. Come on.
Talk. Round two. Trevor Berbick finished the round fast. Now we're in round two. Muhammad Ali, the white trunks with the black stripes and border.
Ali comes out jabbing and moving.
Trevor Berbick in the red border and stripes around the white trunks.
He's dropping his right hand when he's jabbing.
You mean Ali?
Ali, yeah.
But when Berbick tried to counter with that left hook, he still got away from it, so that's what counts.
That's right.
Ali is a retreating fighter right now. Berbick is trailing him. Ali pecking away with the left, but they are not landing. Berbick is concentrated on the body.
He's got to get out of that corner.
Zach Clayton getting them apart. Ali beat him to the punch, but then Berbick came at him.
Get out of there. You hold on. Come on, get out. Come on.
Ali winching as those punches are hitting his body. He's got a nice frown on his face.
Zach Clayton is a no-nonsense referee, no matter who's in there.
Berbick is mad. He's saying, why Ali?
Ali was a sitting duck there. And he's being belabored by Berbick. Ali doing the holding.
Yeah, he's back to his old habit of putting his hand around the man's neck.
Berbick doesn't like the chance of Ali.
Berbick is moving in disdainful of Ali.
Come on, God.
He's contemptuous of him. Ali putting on a rally.
He hasn't really landed any punches, though.
No, not good.
Not at all. They're sliding off Berbick's head.
Fire on it! Keep firing on it! Keep firing on it!
The alley reflexes are gone. He knows what to do, but he can't do it. At least he can't up to now.
He just can't put it together. It's the weight that's slowing him down and the age that's slowing him down. He's got the moves, they're just too slow.
Berbick is just standing there and moving away from him.
Like right there when he cocked up with the right hand. That's what he's doing.
That's a good punch.
The first punch.
Now Ali winces. Ali has nailed Berbick some good punches.
Come on.
Ali putting on a good show. Zach Clayton is saying work.
Good right hand by Ali. Counter punch over the jab. Another right hand by Ali.
Ali's having a good round now.
Come on. Get off. Come on. Hey!
I'll definitely give that round to Ali.
Oh, I think so.
You know, another
thing. He got back to his corner very slowly, however. I think he's tiring.
So is Berbick breathing hard now. He's breathing a little harder now. He's breathing a little harder now, and I think if Ali keep watching for the next couple of rounds, this is going to be a very, very interesting fight.
Interesting already. There's Trevor Berbick in his corner.
Use your right hand. Stop it. Stop the jab on. Just keep on it, Berbick. Don't lay in front of this man. Hold out just like you did the first one.
Rob is talking to Berbick.
You can help yourself in the sense of pushing off what you're doing. It's okay.
Stay back.
Oh, come on.
Round three, Muhammad Ali. White chunks, black stripe and border. Trevor Berbick, the white chunks and the red stripe and border.
Ali keeps jabbing him, keeping him off balance.
Some good jabs by Ali, yep, sticking him out there.
They are good.
They're finally landing.
Ali's looking to set him up with one good right hand.
Ooh, good right hand.
Beautiful right hand.
Ali takes the return punches. Return punches that are good.
Come on, let's go.
We're in round three of this 10-rounder.
Berbick
trailing him in there. Ali could always take a good punch, no matter who fought it.
I think Ali's a little bit surprised when he stepped back. He said, "Well, like, what's going on here?" Because Berbick doesn't quit.
There's a rally by Ali.
One punch rally, but it landed.
Another rally by Ali. But he doesn't sustain it too long. Ali having a good round now, but Berbick is back at him, and he may have hurt him with that hook. From the first round, Berbick has gone for the body. Ali has gone for the head. Time running out in the round, a little more than half a minute. Ali's short with the jabs.
Come on, get off. Come on, work. Work, come on.
Ali in his own corner, holding on.
Get out, come on. All right, let's work, come on.
Ali in trouble over there, not getting hurt, but he's bothered.
Come on, let's work, come on. Hey, bell, come on. Okay, baby.
My goodness, Ali just walked back reeling.
You know, but there's grease on Ali's arm for some reason. Good right hand by Ali.
Beautiful right hand.
Come down. That's what Ali's been trying to do this whole fight, but he hasn't been able to do it.
What do you think of Ali's condition, fellas?
I think Ali's starting to tire him. I really do. And he reeled back.
A lot of good body punches.
Yeah. He's reeling back, going back to his corner, and that scares me a little bit about him.
Don't hesitate.
Come on.
You, but keep
it. Well, they got a 39-year-old, Ali, and a 27-year-old, Trevor Berbick.
Okay.
Good enough to go 15 rounds with Larry Holmes.
When he come in full, time up.
Just warm up.
Time up.
Round four of a 10-rounder.
Well, this is a fight that I wouldn't be too sure Berbick's ahead.
It's close enough. Both have white trunks. As he joined us late, Berbick has the red stripe and border, Ali the black stripe and border. Berbick goes jabbing for the head for a change. He's mostly worked the body.
That was a good shot to the chest by Berbick with a left hook.
Ali a little bit tentative.
And almost got hit for it.
These are solid punches. They're just above us. Berbick is pounding everything in on Ali. He's got him against the ropes. He's really trying to level him. Ali always could take a punch, but now he's in trouble.
Yep, he looks like he's in trouble. He got hit a couple times to the head after Berbick went to the body and straight up. Got by his defense.
Berbick's after him. Ali retreating.
I'm very concerned.
It's a tough round for Ali.
I am too.
Very
to tell
concerned.
The truth. Ali's still trying his heart out, but it's
Berbick,
not there.
Berbick is coasting a little bit as Ali holds on.
Come on.
A minute and a half to go in the round. That's a long time.
I'm going to tell you again that Berbick's breathing hard.
Take it. Come on, come on, come on. Get out of there.
Well, he's thrown a lot of punches, Davey.
Yes, he has.
Berbick coasting a little, trying to get in there. Still works the body.
Take it down. Come on, let's work. Come on, let's work, man.
Berbick is breathing extremely hard,
isn't he?
Come on.
He's very hard.
Ali holding on.
Okay, you got it. Come on. Work, come on. Let's work. Let's work, fellas.
Berbick may be a little arm weary.
You look a little tired, do you now? Oh, come on.
Three punch combination by Ali.
Berbick came back with a big one, too.
Shook him.
Good rally by Ali here.
Come on.
Ali was rocked back by that right hand.
Come on.
Berbick is punching back now.
It's a real fight.
Here they come.
Here's Berbick going to the body. And now he's going to switch up to the head. And this is where Ali took a couple bad punches. Right there inside.
Playing the rope-a-dope, and that's no good. That's one of his faults. He backed out of it now, and he came back a little bit at the end of the round. Berbick's really breathing hard. I don't think he's in good shape right now.
Well, Berbick, he looks a little more recuperated than he was. But he's still breathing extremely hard.
All
he's
right,
breathing,
hard,
breathing hard, harder than
out.
Ali.
Four. Corner down. Come on, get out of there, Brock. Get out of there. Hit that stool out of there.
Round five. Ali gets off the stool very slowly. Berbick trots out after him.
Ali's in extremely good shape. He's just too slow
Ali
to do anything.
Ali is rocked back by another left hand.
The left hand didn't hit him, just threw him off balance.
The age-old habit of him having his hand around the neck and the guy's banging him in the body.
Punches like that can really wear Berbick out. He's breathing as hard as he is. That's what's wearing him out.
Berbick gets off quickly in the round all the time. Ali tries to come back at the end of the round.
Nothing left.
So far, it's been all Berbick in this round.
Ali is blocked by those right hands.
Okay, okay. Not really tied up.
But he dodged the second one. He missed the second one.
There he goes.
Ali throwing a good right hand.
These are terrific body punches. Now the head punches.
Ali
takes a lot of punishment without a return.
Should get out of the corner now.
They're in a neutral corner just above us. Jack Clayton keeps yelling, let's work. I think they're working pretty good.
Goodness, I don't know what he wants.
Well, Ali was holding a little bit. He wants to see a little bit of action.
Ali left himself open and was tagged.
Not very hard. Ali's rolling out a few of these punches, catching them on the top of his arms. He caught those two real good.
Punch out and get out. Punch out and get out. Punch out and get out.
Ali making the clinches.
Berbick slowed up some.
Get off. Come yes. on over here. Let's go. Come on.
Ali, I think, feels that too, and he's trying to make an advantage.
If Ali had anything left now, he could get him.
I'll take it, fellas. Get out. Both of you tied up. Come on. Okay, you got it.
That's Zach Clayton doing the talking.
That third punch got in and lost three after that. Every time Berbick gets hit, he gets mad. Good left hook by Ali.
Beautiful.
He tried to follow up and couldn't do it. Good left hook by Berbick.
Ali putting on a rally here. Berbick had the beginning of the round, and Ali came back.
Good right hand by Ali. Sets Berbick back a little bit. Ali coming in.
Big round, big round. You got to keep fighting him. Keep throwing your punches. Keep throwing your punches. Keep throwing your punches. You got it. I'm telling you. But keep throwing these at him. Yeah. You got to look how tired he is. But you got to use this hand, not that, and come back.
Tell him, dude.
Come on, Chuck.
Ali getting worked on by Angelo Dundee in his corner.
Hit him on them targets.
It's number five. Come on, we're halfway home. Halfway home.
That was Angelo saying that was number five. We're halfway home.
Find the target, Chuck. Find the target,
Chuck. You had three guys yelling at Ali between rounds, trying to inspire him.
Ali looks like he's trying to move around and land out those punches again. Waiting for the
Ali chance. Keeps pecking away with that left hand, and Berbick tries to set him up for his own left hand. Berbick continues to work the body. Ali tries to fight back with his own left hand. Berbick coming in on him again with solid punches.
With flurry.
It's a big rally for Berbick, who always starts the
Ali tries
path.
To hold on.
Ali beckons his man in. Berbick keeps him against the ropes. The referee is dancing around them. Ali still beckons Berbick in. He doesn't have to do that. Berbick will come in anyway.
Let's go work. Come on, both of them. Let's work. Come on.
I don't know what the referee is yelling, let's work for. They're doing plenty of work. Ali back and towards the ropes again. That's where he's been in trouble through the fight.
Get out of the corner. He did.
He got out behind the left jab.
Quirk, come on, both of you. Let's go. Come on. Quirk, come on. Come on. Quirk, both of you. Let's go. Come on.
Those were good punches by Berbick.
Ali's short with those lefts.
Like he used to be.
Ali straight back and shows the ropes again. Then he gets out.
Good punch.
Good combination.
Good rally by Ali, but there's Berbick back at him.
Come on, let's work. Come on.
It's been certainly a better fight than anybody thought it would be.
Berbick, let's work. Come on, work.
Ali still takes his punch as good as anybody in the ring.
Ali's looking for that right hand, it looks like. Keeping him off with his jab.
So far, it's been a good round for Ali.
Hi.
30 seconds left in the round.
Mr. Berbick's punches don't have the authority anymore.
They're both tiring a little bit. Ali trying to set himself there. Berbick keeps him to the punch.
All these punches look like they're slowing up.
Ali's pushing the right hand now.
How much more credit could you give a man like Ali doing what he's doing, putting up the argument in the fight that he's putting up against such a younger man?
That's right. Absolutely.
Man, it's just unbelievable.
Veronica Ali in the audience. And John Travolta. Right.
There he is. Looking right into the camera.
You'll get him. Don't punch him.
Well, Jim, what do you think at this point? Jim Hill.
Don't have to tell you, a lot of people here at ringside have been commenting about Ali and how slow he is in throwing his punches. He's telegraphing his punches, but still, he is surprising a lot of people.
Round 7, Muhammad Ali, Trevor Berbick. It's scheduled for 10. There have been no knockdowns. Nobody's been seriously hurt. Berbick trying to get in on Ali again. Ali pecking away with the left to keep him off.
Doing a good job of it.
It's a crazy left hook landed by Berbick.
Now Ali's covering up.
All right, I'll take that hand out of here.
And they okay, must say through the fight, Ali has made most of the clinches, done most of the holding. Berbick all over Ali and on the ropes.
Two of those right hands landing just fairly effectively.
A lot of them are getting in.
You work your way out of there, both of you. Fight your way out. Both of you, let's get off. Let's get off.
Ali against the ropes again. Berbick on top of him. It's Berbick doing the landing.
This to me is Ali's biggest mistake.
Berbick is giving him no rest right now. Ali is taking a lot of punishment, but he always could.
This is Berbick's game plan, is to get in and try to wear Ali out, throw a lot of punches and try to look good and win these rounds.
That's what he's doing.
Keep your hands up. Work, come on.
Ali was really hurt that time. He's wincing. He's getting a little gun shy, and he's worried. Berbick's all over him in this round. Ali taking a battering on the ropes.
Berbick looks like he's picking it up.
Both can put him on his show. 45 seconds to go in the round.
I think Berbick just looked at Zach
Berbick
Clayton.
Putting everything into his punches, head and body now.
Berbick at this point is thinking that Clayton should stop the fight.
Yes, that's what he was yelling to the referee.
Yeah, he yelled at him for that.
Come on, get that hand out of there. Come on.
Berbick don't like Ali holding behind the head.
Ali has done nothing for the last 2 minutes of this round. but take punishment.
Hurt, hurt.
He's trying to keep Berbick away. He's trying to put on a rally now. But Berbick is still on top of him.
Here you see Ali staying, almost being stubborn about staying up against the ropes, and this is where Berbick gets him. And then when he holds his hand around his neck, Berbick bangs him in the body and never stops.
Yeah, that's when Berbick gets mad. He hates being held.
I wonder if Ali stays on the ropes because he's too tired to get out in the center. Maybe it gives you a certain security, does it, Randy? You know, if you've been on the ropes.
I would know. I can fight against the ropes.
If you can.
A fighter does fights against the ropes, but Ali does it for protection. And I don't know his strategy, but figuring that he'll wear out or let up, but Berbick isn't letting up.
Well, I think Ali had his worst round of the fight. He took a bad beating.
That was Ali's worst round.
Round 8 of a 10-rounder, Ali goes dancing for a change and pecking away. The old Ali dance, the shuffle.
Caught him with a beautiful left hook.
Berbick doesn't believe it. There's Ali dancing for the first time tonight. Up on his toes. But it may be from memory.
His corner is yelling at Ali to dance. That's what Ali has to do the whole fight, is stick out his jab and stay away.
The crowd has come alive. He's keeping Berbick off.
Berbick is going to come in throwing wild punches any minute.
He will.
That's what all he has to do is tie him up on the inside.
I wonder how long he can dance this way, though.
Well, he looks in like he's in good shape.
Got nailed in.
That actually left hook grazed off the back of the head. Wasn't that hard.
Ali pecking away like the Ali of old. A perfect kick coming in on him.
Not only is Ali dancing, but his punches are fairly effective.
Punch out of good out. Come on. Come on, let's go. Come on. Come on.
Ali is holding on.
Berbick's very tired now.
I have a feeling Berbick won't stop. He's going to keep coming in.
Ali rocked into the ropes by that left hand. And the right.
That took the partially blocked. Those aren't those.
Berbick is all over him. Ali can still dance.
An amazing man.
Oh, I'll take it for the day. I'll come out.
An nice amazing night in the Bahamas.
Nice
going. Ali scouted the polo, but it got picked off in midair.
That was a good counterpunch by Berbick.
Oh, yes. He's hitting solidly. Ali jabbing again as Berbick comes in wide open. Good jab down the right.
That was a good combination by Muhammad Ali.
But Berbick is on him again.
That's what Ali has to do, is tie him up on the inside and stay on the outside.
It's been a good round for the ex-champion. 10 seconds left.
Yes, it's a fairly close fight with Berbick maybe a little bit ahead. Of course, depending on how the judges see it, I would see it that way. When you talk about drama in the Bahama, that's putting it mildly. This is the most amazing exhibition I've ever seen.
I think Ali is doing very, very well. He looks very sharp there. If he can do it for two more rounds,
he has a chance of pulling this fight out, but it's really hard to say. The fight's a very hard fight to judge.
He's got to jab and stay away from the ropes.
Yeah, if he can jab on the outside and clinch on the inside and stop Berbick from throwing, that's what he has to do, is stop it.
Round nine. Who thought it would go this far? Trevor Berbick with the red stripe and border. Muhammad Ali with the black stripe and border, both wearing white trunks.
Well, this goes to prove one thing, that extra weight really hasn't stopped Ali's condition anyway. He's in very good shape, which he told a lot of people he was.
And I didn't think he could dance seven or eight rounds of action that way.
No, especially Berbick, after the punches he's taken.
Berbick's backing him into the ropes again.
He tries to get out. He's nailed by a couple of good punches.
Luckily, they were grazed off his left foot, off his left cheek.
Ali may be entertaining the crowd, but he's not scoring punches here.
Berbick trying to throw out of desperation to try to stop Ali, and now throw in his combination. Ali's staying on the outside. That's keeping his jab going.
Jabbing again. Berbick can't get started in this round, but now he does. Ali making the clinch. Throughout the fight, it has been Ali doing the holding. Berbick a little bit frustrated here.
Don, that's a lot of experience going on out there.
Berbick's trying to throw a lot of fast punches. Not real effective or hard, but a lot of fast punches just to land them.
He's forcing Ali back to the ropes again. Ali is holding on. Ali a little bit short with those jabs, but Berbick wasn't short.
Break yourself. Get out of here. Get out of here. Come on.
About three quarters of a minute left to go in the round. Berbick all over Ali again.
No punches landing real effectively, but that's what Berbick wants to do, throw a lot of punches.
That was a good one.
Punch out, get out. Punch out. Punch out, get out. Punch out, get out. Come on, punch out, get out.
Our referee are here. Ali's against the ropes, trying to lean back, getting away from Berbick's punches.
Punch out, get out. Punch out, get out. Come on.
Berbick landing some good punches while Ali tries to hold on.
Yeah, some good punches were landed.
Punch out and get out. Punch out and get out. Hey!
One more round. One more round.
Ali looks pretty tired now.
Yes, he's
looks very,
very
tired.
I think he's exhausted already.
Well, I'll say this, in all honesty, win, lose, or draw here, I hope he doesn't fight again.
I pray he doesn't fight again. I'm worried about this man fighting anymore at all.
That's all. You got the dance.
We may overlook, we think of the old Ali, and he puts it on these flashes, dances around a little bit, and then he jabs and jabs, but Berbick is landing the punches. No question about it. And he's hurting him.
Get up now.
I've got Berbick.
Ali looks flashy, sure, at times, when you think of the old Ali. There it is. The 10th and final round. Zach Clayton hasn't touched gloves. Who will be there? Ali goes to dancing. Berbick is dancing. Berbick's on top of him.
Angelo Dundee was yelling to him, go, 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 go. Get out there and dance. This is what Ali's trying to do. This round, he wants to stay away and use that jab. Good combination
Berbick,
by Ali.
Berbick holds him against the ropes again, over in Berbick's corner. some fight, hasn't it, fellas?
Very good.
Oh, fantastic fight. Even though this is a 10-round fight, this is history.
Ali is trying. So is Berbick. Berbick ripping the body again. Referee says, this is it, let's go. It is, this is it.
Ali is trying to exchange with him. I don't know if that's so good. Ali has to stay on his toes and dance.
About a minute and a half left to go in the fight in this 10th and final round here in the Bahamas, Nassau, Bahamas.
Berbick swinging like a wild man again, just trying to land those punches.
Berbick's throwing out all the stops. He's all over Ali on the ropes.
A minute and 20 to go.
Berbick dancing into action, driving Ali back again, and the ex-champ has to hold on. Ali in his own corner, being battered.
Ali looks like he's getting very tired.
Less than a minute to go now. Ali holding on.
Ali has to move, and he's done. He's just standing there.
He's driven back to the ropes again. Berbick from down under.
Ali's punches are barely getting out there.
Ali wants to put on a last second rally. 30 seconds left to go. Berbick drives him back again. There have been no knockdowns in the fight.
Those are two good
punches by Berbick. Big punches. The biggest of the fight. 10 seconds.
There'd be no knockout now.
There it is. It's all over.
What a fight.
Tremendous fight. A tremendous
Very
effort.
Good fight.
We saw an amazing fight. Ali in much better condition than they thought he would be.
Thank you.
A lot of people getting up in the ring. We're gonna have some interviews by Jim Hill and Davey Pearl. Jim is going to get over with Muhammad Ali. My view is being blocked here by the people up on the ropes. I see Howard Bingham, the photographer, a longtime friend of Muhammad Ali, he's up there. I kind of lost track of Trevor Berbick in the crowd up there in the ring. Look at that crowd, it's building and building. We had a fine turnout here tonight at the Queen Elizabeth Sports Center in Nassau, Bahamas. And we saw some fight card. And the promoters who put it on, people connected with it, deserve a lot of credit because they, if anybody could have been discouraged this week, they could have been. But they weren't. Davey Pearl and Jim Hill are both up in the ring. I hope they can get near the gladiators. We're waiting for the decision now. The scoring on the 10-point must system, 10 points to the winner of a round, 9 or less to the loser. 10 points each in an easy, even round. There were no knockdowns. Big crowd around Ali.
The ring must be cleared or we cannot have a decision. We must clear the ring.
Matt Helrich, the ring announcer, says
all
the ring must be cleared
clear
or we cannot have a decision.
You'll all be given a chance.
Fair enough.
Please.
I wish they'd all
we
get out of there.
We cannot have a decision until the ring is clear.
Now they're coming out of the ring. Still a crowd in there, though. I said, all it is here, man.
I made my living in television for a long time.
Everybody who does not belong, please clear the ring.
They're trying to get the ring cleared, and they're not too successful of it.
Am I supposed to break?
Let's see if we can get Jim Hill in here. He's over in Muhammad Ali's corner. Can you hear me, Jim?
I can hear you, Don. And of course, everyone in Ali's corner feels that he won the fight by a decision. Drew Boondini, Brown, Wallace Muhammad, the rest of them over there cheering him. Jimmy Ellis, who Ali beat one time before and now came back. And of course, everybody here feels, Don, that Ali really won the fight. People are hugging each other, and of course, it is really a tremendous thing that has happened here, because for a long time, everyone that I talked to was hoping that Ali could win the fight. They didn't know that he could win the fight. They were hoping that actually he wouldn't come in here. But then, of course, after everything happened, once he got in here, I think the crowd got behind him, and of course, Trevor Berbick knew that Muhammad Ali would be the sentimental favorite going into the fight. One of the things that we noticed at ringside was that the slowness of Ali. However, in round 10, Trevor Berbick came out, and it looked as though he knew that he was going to have to knock him out in order to win it. Berbick is walking around. He's been holding his hands up in the air as though he did win the fight. However, there is a look of gloom in his eyes as though he may have figured that he did lose it by a decision.
Jim, it's almost like election night while the candidates
Please
wait for the returns
away,
to come in.
No,
did you hear me? I said it's almost like election night with the candidates waiting for the returns to come in.
That's right, and everybody on each side is saying that their candidate happened to win until the actual vote does come in. But
let's see where Davy Pearl is up there. Davy, can you hear me?
Yes.
Go ahead.
I don't want you to win, but Trevor.
I'm going to try to hurt him. I didn't want to win.
Trevor.
No, I hit him with the right hand, and all I could think about is man getting hurt.
Trevor, face the camera.
Stop there putting the truth since I've been here.
Face the camera.
Huh, how you doing?
Trevor, you're a good looking guy. Don't be afraid of the camera.
No,
okay?
I'm not.
Okay, Trevor, what are your plans now for the future?
Right, I'm waiting on this decision. I know I won the fight, no doubt about it. I gave him a lot of time. I shoot him off and back off instead of loading up.
All right, let's assume you won the fight. What are your plans for
the future? I want to go for the World Heavyweight Championship.
Have you got any potential fights lined up?
Or? Yeah, there's quite a few I could fight. I've been getting a lot of offers, but it's just a matter of accepting them, depends on the conditions. This one was awful. Since I get here, it was a mental strain that put me through.
You figure it hurt you physically, huh?
Man, it hurt me mentally so bad that physically I'm tired. Even today, they had me weighed on my retirement reporter since yesterday. Tired, wear me out. They did it deliberately, I know it. Just for Holly to be in better shape physically and mentally. But I survive and I overcome, I know it.
Seemed like earlier in the fight you were talking to him.
Close. Yeah, because
what were you saying?
I just told him, do the best you can, because I don't want to hurt you.
Did he answer you?
He was saying, you know, sort of sad. That sad look in his face. He's hard, man.
Matt Helrich is trying to get the decision made. He's looking over the card. Here it is.
You're supposed to be in here.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a unanimous decision. Judge Alonzo Butler votes it 97-94. Judge Clyde Gray votes 99-94. Judge Jay Etson votes 99-94. Unanimous decision for Trevor Berbick.
Well, there you have it. Trevor Berbick is the unanimous decision. Judge Butler, 97-94. Judge Gray, 99-94. And Jay Edson, 99-94. It was a unanimous decision. And all the glamour around. Let's go, Jim Hill. Jim Hill, can you hear me?
I can hear you, Don. Now, that's the center of the ring right now. Trevor Berbick and Muhammad Ali are hugging each other. Berbick is telling Ali that, listen to this.
And I shall go on to win the world championship. Wait till you see me next time, Shine. I've been doing all the things. I could have done it with you, man. You're my superior. But I'm going to do it for you, man. You inspire me since I've been a kid. I love you, man. You're a true brother, man. I love you. Thank you, man. You made me. Bless you. Pray for you.
Muhammad. Muhammad.
There's still a madhouse in the ring.
Muhammad, can I get you just for a second, Muhammad? Muhammad, can I get you just for a second? There were some people at ringside that thought that you might have won this thing by going the distance, like you said you did.
Man, it was close. It was close. And I have to submit to the judges. He was strong. He was good. I think you won.
Do you agree now? Do you agree now, Muhammad, that you should retire and never come back in this ring again? Muhammad, has it settled in your mind now, after losing, that this is it for you? You should never come back in this ring again?
I'm sure that this is enough to convince me. I didn't get hurt. I saw the shot, couldn't take them. Father Time just got it.
It looked to us at ringside that, you know, you were slow, you were telegraphing your punches. The eyes could see it, but the physical ability just couldn't get it there.
That's right. I think that's the trouble. Father Time called. In my young days, I wouldn't have had much trouble. But I think time got it.
And this is it for you?
I'm sure it is. This is it. I'm sure I won't wake up next week. Sam will come back. As of now, I'm retired. I don't think I changed my mind.
Muhammad, thank you so very much, and thank you from all of us around the world.
Thank you.
Don Dunphy, back to you.
All right, Jim Hill, thank you very much. We have seen possibly the end of a great champion, but in all fairness, Trevor Berbick won the fight, and it's to the credit of the Bahamian officials that they scored it as it was and not by memory. I want to congratulate my colleagues, Jim Hill and Davey Pearl and Randy Shields. It's certainly been a pleasure working with you. It's been a great night here in the Bahamas. Thank you very much. Okay.